What does our body language tell others about us? It was quite popular, particularly in the 1970s and 1980s, for people to write books about body language. These books promised that if you could learn the secrets of body language, you'd be able to effectively read people's minds, to know what they were thinking if they crossed their arms or scratched their nose or looked to the left. Maybe you could even convince them to like you more through adjusting your own body language. For the most part, these claims are massively overstated. Despite what your friends think, when you study psychology, you aren't going to learn how to read people's minds. Having said that, nonverbal communication is a major avenue through which we reach other people. It's a major avenue through which we miscommunicate as well. We'll talk about the role of hand gestures and the role of facial expressions, particularly because the face is good at communicating emotion. We'll also talk about cross-cultural differences in nonverbal communication. Then, we're going to be dabbling in some interpretation of body language ourselves as we try to answer the question of whether we can tell if someone is lying on the basis of their body language. So what do we mean by nonverbal communication? It's a much broader definition than many people imagine. It's effectively anything other than the words. Obviously, this includes things like hand gestures and facial expressions. It can also include things like your voice, whether you've got a high-pitched voice or a loud voice. It can include posture, touch, clothes, a whole range of things, actually. There's nothing in the definition that suggests that nonverbal communication has to be intentional. When you put clothes on this morning, presumably you were not necessarily trying to send the message to the world about how you're feeling or the kind of person that you are. But some people might make those assumptions about you in any case. According to the definition, communication has happened with or without your permission, with or without your intention. There's nothing in the definition that suggests that it has to be accurate. People can make all sorts of mistaken assumptions on the basis of your body language, your clothes, whatever it is, but that's still nonverbal communication.